Hi, hello, and welcome once again to the book show where we are reading our first book, The Mini Habits by Stephen Covey. So all this day we were looking about what is mini habits and why is it important. And yesterday we also saw how it is different from every other systems out there claiming to change your life. But today is the day you have all been waiting for. Today we are going to see how we are going to do it, because that is what matters, right? So welcome to the day seven of mini habits. Today we are going to see the step-by-step application guide to choose and implement your own mini habits, and the real fun begins now. So the step number one, choose your mini habits and habit plan. So make a quick list of habits that you would like to have at some point. If you have an idea, yeah, don't worry, the author has suggested minihabits.com, a website where there is a tons of mini habits that you could choose from. Okay, now the link in the description, go and check it. The step number two, use the why drill on each mini habit. It's because the simple question why is the best way to drill down to the core of anything. So once you have listed your habits, identify why you want to learn them, but don't stop there. Ask why again. So edukaga indha why na ipo or mini habit choose panikenga ungale kelunga, why are you choosing that? Adha vachi neenga enna panna poringa? So or answer varum, but ask again why. So neenga ipdi indha kelvi yen iruka yen pandra yen pandra nu kekumbodhu, you know why you are doing it and you go to the core of it. The step number 3, define your habit cues. The two common habit cues are time based and activity based. So ipo time based la vandha you are going to say that I will do exercise at 3 p.m. but in an activity based cue you will say that you will do exercise after you have had your last bite of lunch. Okay, the people with 9-to-5 jobs have structured schedules, so the time based cue works for them, and for the people who are having more flexibility can choose the activity based cue, but it depends on your lifestyle. The step number 4 is create your reward plan. Even if it's a mini habit, you need to have a reward for it, then only the brain would love to do it. The step number 5, write everything down. So one study found that all thoughts, positive or negative, held greater prominence in the mind when written down on the paper. The same impact had not been found for typing. You have got to handwrite it to amplify it. Neenga manasla vechittavo illa type panni or paper la print out edichittalo id valikkavathu. You need to write it down so that it stays on your mind. So it is also helpful for tracking your progress, and the author suggests to check this paper before you go to sleep so that you don't forget anything. Step number 6, think small. Why are we making these habits so small when we could aim higher? And what if you stop at your smaller goal? Is it still useful? Yes, and it has to do with willpower. You already seen in the previous videos why willpower is so important, and here the author says that willpower can be strengthened like a muscle. So mini habits is going to strengthen this. So we want to do things on the road to habit. The first thing is strengthen our willpower, the make progress in the present moment and not exhaust our willpower. Step number 7, meet your schedule and drop high expectations. Expectations are a tricky thing in life. It's helpful to have generally high expectations for yourself because it increases your ceiling. In other words, if you don't believe you can be in good shape, you never will be. If you never try to get in good shape, it's never going to happen. And the last step, watch for the signs of habit, but be careful not to jump the gun. This step is another reminder of patience. The mini habit strategy works, but if you drop a behavior before it's truly habit and go on to add your next set of habits, then you're going to risk dropping everything like an unskilled juggler. So here the author tells us some signs that it has become a habit. The first thing is the resistance. There should be no resistance. The second thing is identity. You can completely and confidently say that I am a writer, or I read books, or I do exercise. The third is the mindless action. You will engage in a behavior without making an executive decision. Fourth thing is you don't worry about it. Starting out, you might worry about missing a day or quitting early, but when behavior is habit, you know that you will be doing it unless there is an emergency. And the last thing is normalization. Habits are non-emotional. You're not going to be excited that you're really doing it once the habit. When a behavior makes the transition to normalcy, it's a habit. So that's it, guys. And these are the 8 steps that you're going to implement it now after watching this video. please do write in comments after you try this. And tomorrow is the last day of the series, and see you there. Bye.